Good morning, everyone. I am Mohitika Pai. Here I want to discuss with you about the nodal analysis of the site. After watching this video, you will develop knowledge about the circuits and networks, develop an understanding of the fundamental laws like Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's law, Thevenin's law, etc., and elements of circuit, electric circuit, and develop the ability to apply circuit analysis to a DC and AC circuit. So, here we first of all, you have to know that what is circuit and what is network. Here we see, you can see a network. Many times it is called by us as a network, many times called it is a circuit. Is there any difference? Yes, there is a difference. The interconnection of two or more simple circuit element is called an electric circuit, just like this diagram. And if the network contains at least one closed path, it is called an electric circuit, just like this diagram. Okay, so here three closed loop is there, three closed loop are there, so it is called an electric circuit. So every electric circuit is a network, but not all networks are circuits. Okay, now we have to know that what is node analysis. So first of all, we have to know that what is node. Node, it is a point where branches are connected. The aim of nodal analysis is to determine the voltage at each node relative to the reference node. So here in this diagram, this is a node, this is also a node, this is also a node, this is a node. So where the branches are connected. Okay. Now, here in this diagram, in this circuit, four nodes are there. So if a three node circuit should have two unknown voltages and two one equation, so n node circuit will need n minus 1 voltages and n minus 1 equations. So here we use 4 node. Okay. So we have to select one node as a reference node. Then define a voltage between each remaining node and the reference node. Hence we note again that there will be only n minus 1 voltages defined in an n node circuit. So here we chose the third number node as a reference node. Anyone can be a reference node, but a little simplification in the resultant equation is obtained if the node to which the greatest number of branches are connected. So here four branches are connected in this node, so that's why it is called a reference node. Okay, so the voltage of node 1 relative to node 3 is defined as V1, and voltage of node 2 with reference to node 3 is defined as V2. Thus, two voltages are sufficient, and the voltage between any other pair of nodes may be found in terms of them. Okay, so the voltage of node 1 with respect to voltage of node 2 is V1 minus V2. Voltage V1 minus V2. So here we can apply KCL, Kirchhoff's current law. Okay, so applying Kirchhoff's current law at node 1, we can get the voltage V1 by 2 v1 by 2 plus v1 minus v2 by 5 equal to 3.1. So incoming current is equal to the outgoing current. Incoming current is 3.1 ampere and outgoing current is v1 by 2 and v1 minus v2 by 5. At node 2, we can again apply KCL. So here, incoming current, all are the outgoing current. So you can write down it as a v1 v2 plus 1 by 5 into v2 minus v1 equal to 1.4. So solving this two equation, we can get the result. So v1 is equal to 5 volt, v2 is equal to 2 volt. So any current or power in the circuit may now be found in one state. For example, the current directed downward through the 2 ohm resistor is 0.5 V1 or 2.5 ampere. Okay. Now again, that in this example, we have 4 node. So we assume that this is the reference node and this is V1, V2 and V3. Here we can see that in this branch there is only a voltage source. So if we try to do apply the KCL we apply in the previous example, then we shall run into some difficulty at both node 2 and 3, for we do not know what is the current in the branch with the voltage source, because we know that voltage source is independent of current. Okay. So there is no way by which we can express the current as a function of voltage. So this is node. So here we can assume that this V2 and V3 is a single node. V2 and V3 is a single node. This is known as a super node. Okay. So this is a single node, V2 and V3. So outgoing current is this one, and this one. And incoming current is 25 ampere. Okay. So this is called a super node. So this is the nodal analysis. In our face-to-face class, we can solve or we can take example of the nodal analysis and we can solve the nodal analysis problem. Thank you.